In part 5 of our lesson on powers and roots of complex numbers, you will learn how to find roots of unity and represent them geometrically. Let's look at this example. The instructions say to find the 8/8 roots of unity and represent them geometrically. Use degree angles in your trig form, then put your final answer in rectangular form. So our first step is to draw Z and put it into trig form. Now in this case, you might be wondering what Z is. Well, Z comes from this word, unity, in this case. And unity in the complex number system just means that Z is equal to 1. Now, if we draw a quick picture of that, to say that Z is equal to 1 is the same thing as saying Z equals 1 plus 0i. So that means our x value is 1 and our y value is 0. So this is Z. This is another one of those cases where it's really easy to see what r and theta have to be. R is going to equal 1 and theta is going to equal 0 degrees. So then that means in trig form, Z is going to equal 1 sis 0 degrees. Step 2 is to get the formula for the alpha k's. And from our definition, we know that alpha k will be the nth root of r sis theta plus 360 degrees times k over n. And since we are finding the 8/8 roots, we know that n is equal to 8. From the trig form of Z, we know that r is equal to 1 and that theta is equal to 0 degrees. So then our alpha k is going to be the 8th root of 1 sis 0 degrees plus 360 degrees times k divided by 8. Simplifying, we get alpha k is equal to 1 sis 360 divided by 8 is 45, so this is 45 degrees times k, and we know that we will plug in k is equal to 0, 1, etc., all the way up to 7. Step 3 is to calculate the alpha k's. Alpha 0 is going to equal 1 sis 45 degrees times 0. So that's 1 cis 0 degrees, which we know is 1 times the cosine of 0 is equal to 1 plus I times the sine of 0, which is 0. So this is equal to 1 plus 0i. Now, to represent them geometrically just means to put them on a graph. One plus zero I is pretty easy to graph. We know we'll just go out here to one. And there is alpha zero. Another way to graph it, instead of the rectangular form, is to use the trig form. This just says go to an angle of zero and go out a distance of one. That would be the same vector. Alpha 1 is equal to 1 cis 45 degrees times 1, which of course is 1 cis 45 degrees, which is 1. We have to take the cosine of 45 degrees, radical 2 over 2, plus I times the sine of 45 degrees, which is also radical 2 over 2. Simplifying, this is radical 2 over 2 plus radical 2 over 2 times I. Now we can graph this in its rectangular form, or I think this is much easier to think of in the trig form, which says go to an angle of 45 degrees and out a radius of 1. So it's like this, think of this radius swinging around here. So there is alpha 1. Alpha 2 is equal to 1 cis 45 degrees times 2, which we know is 1 cis 90 degrees, which is 1 multiplied by the cosine of 90, which is 0, plus I times the sine of 90, which is positive 1. So this becomes 0 plus I. We know the real part is 0, the imaginary part is 1, so x is 0, y is 1, or again, you can think of it as going to an angle of 90 and going a distance of 1. So there's alpha 2. Alpha 3 is 1 cis 45 degrees times 3, which is 1 cis 135 degrees, which is 1 times the quantity cosine of 135 degrees, negative root 2 over 2, plus I times the sine of 135 degrees, positive root 2 over 2. So this simplifies to negative radical 2 over 2 plus radical 2 over 2 I. Once again, I think the rectangular coordinates are a little harder to graph than the trig form, which says go to an angle of 135 degrees and go out a radius of 1. So it's like this radius of 1 is swinging around here. This would be alpha 3. Alpha 4 is 1 cis 45 degrees times 4, which is 1 cis 180 degrees. Which is 1 times the cosine of 180 is negative 1 plus I times the sine of 180, which is 0. So this is negative 1 plus 0 I. So that's over here. And that's alpha 4. Alpha 5 will be 1 cis 45 degrees times 5, which is 1 cis 225 degrees. Which means we have to take 1 times the quantity cosine of 225 degrees is negative radical 2 over 2 plus I times the sine of 225 degrees, negative radical 2 over 2. And of course that simplifies to be negative root 2 over 2 minus root 2 over 2 I. You can use the trig form to graph it. Just go to an angle of 225 out to a radius of 1. That's alpha 5. Alpha 6, we have 1 cis 45 degrees times 6. We get 1 cis 270 degrees, which means when we expand it, we get 1 times the quantity cosine of 270 degrees is 0 plus I times the sine of 270 degrees, which is negative 1. This becomes 0 minus I. Pretty easy to graph either in its rectangular or its trig form. There's alpha 6. Alpha 7 is going to be 1 cis 45 degrees times 7. So that's going to be 1 cis 315 degrees, which means we have to take 1 times the quantity cosine of 315 degrees is radical 2 over 2 plus I times the sine of 315 degrees, negative radical 2 over 2. So this simplifies to be radical 2 over 2 minus radical 2 over 2 I. And the rectangular form, probably not as easy to graph as the trig form, so we go to an angle of 315, we go out to that radius of 1, and there's alpha 7. So you can see that all of these basically traced out a circle whose radius is 1. All of the alpha k's had their terminal point on this circle whose radius was 1. Now we wrote out every detail of every step here, but hopefully as you get more comfortable with this, maybe you don't have to write out that first step and you're able to just plug in the k value here, write that out, and get to your final answer quickly. Whatever little detail step you feel comfortable skipping, it's okay. Just make sure you don't skip so much that you get an incorrect answer.